Harry, how about just getting in the right rhythm as a team on the road, that mindset?
Yeah, that's important. That's important for us. You know, that's going to be we're already preparing for that mentally now. You know, we're talking about those kind of things that we're not going to have the support of our fans and you know, we're not going to play at our arena and things like that. So yeah, we have to be ready for it, and we have to find the motivation, you know, when things are going bad, the energy, when things are going bad from the inside of the team, and, you know, that's what we're going to try to do tomorrow.
After playing the 30-plus minutes the other night, how did you feel yesterday with the ankle? Everything felt good?
Yeah, it felt really good, actually. I was surprised. I thought I was going to be a little stiff in the morning or something, but I woke up and it was feeling really good.
So you're confident, like, with the back-to-back here, the problems are behind you now?
I think so. During the game, I didn't even, you know, realize my ankle was, you know, I'm coming back from injury, and the day after also it felt good, so there are no concerns on my side.
So as of now, the plan is to play the back-to-back. You know, I know you've had some things pop up on the back-to-backs.
Yeah, definitely. No, first I want to play, yeah. Especially I've been out now for, you know, four or five days. I didn't really do anything as we're playing, you know, so you know, I'm looking forward to this back-to-back.
How about just, you know, building on, you know, without Tim in the lineup, you know, trying to, you know, pick up offensively?
Yeah. I think Seeley is doing a great job offensively also, you know, being more involved and you know, just playing for the team. And obviously, you know, he's always, every night he's bringing it on the defensive end. You know, for me, he deserves to be in all NBA as a defensive team, you know. And then if he can keep doing what he's doing on the offensive side too, then, I mean, you know, that's big time for us. So I really love how Seeley's playing.
Is there something that Ennis does, having Ennis in the lineup, has it helped you in any way, particularly?
Yeah, I mean, I love playing with Ennis because he's such a big physical center down there, you know. Maybe not as big, but he's physical as hell. Like, one of the strongest guys I know in the league. And he's just there to pick up the rebounds that when I miss shots. And I love playing against him. He also finds me where there are mismatches, you know, found me for the lob late in the game, things like that. So he's looking for me, and I enjoy playing with him.
Is it at all similar to when, I know you guys play Robin tomorrow, mm-hmm. but is it all similar to playing with Robin?
It was, there are a lot of similarities, yeah. I would say Robin is bigger body, like wider and things like that. But physicality, both of them are probably two of the, you know, most strongest guys in the league, their games are kind of similar. Rolo's just wider, I would say.
And have you learned about anything about blocking shots in your NBA career? Do you feel like you've gotten better at that?
I think it's something really natural. I haven't really studied like blocking shots, you know, never. I haven't really done that. I enjoy watching highlights of the best blocks in the history, things like that. But as far as like studying, I haven't really done that. Under 18 championship, I was averaging 5 blocks a game. You know, it kind of came natural to me. And playing the 4-man now, imagine what would I do if I played the 5?
Yeah.
So much of marketing at all, people. There's some similarities in your game. He's had some real success as a rookie so far.
Yeah, no, he's having a great year so far, and we can shoot it from outside, and he's actually much more stronger than I was when I came into the league, and he's I would say he's more NBA ready when I came in. But I think if he can, you know, I was actually surprised to see him perform at that level in the European Championship. You know, so. At that moment, when I saw him, I knew he was going to be able to do damage in the NBA also. And he's having a great year so far. If he can stay healthy, I'll catch up with him.
Had you ever seen him before this summer? Before the championships this summer?
I haven't met him, but we talked to each other and we texted a little bit, things like that. So we've been in contact, yeah, but it's going to be first time meeting.
Did you know that over the summer, when Phil was talking about trading you and everything, that he brought in Markkanen, and everybody was like, oh, that's going to be KP's replacement. Did you hear about it, all that stuff?
I heard about it. I read it on Twitter. It was pretty funny. Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe it was the plan. Maybe it didn't go that way, but I'm happy I'm still here.
What do you think about Kyle as a photographer?
He's actually pretty good. At first, I was a little skeptical. You know, he just doesn't look like the typical photographer, you know. But the pictures that he took of me, obviously, I'm very photogenic and I look good. That's why he wants to take pictures of me, not anybody else. Yeah, it's okay.